Hi, this is the third episode in a series of videos on creating an impact map from scratch in UXPressia's impact mapping tool. And in this episode, I'm going to talk about identifying personas for your impact map. You may ask a reasonable question, why do I need to identify personas? And I will give you a straight answer. Personas will let you clearly understand who is going to help you in achieving your goals. You didn't think that you would reach them on your own, did you? At this point, I want to make sure you realize that your personas are not only your customers and users, but everyone else whose decisions can influence the project's outcome or the success of a specific project milestone. This means your personas can be a UX designer, HR manager, UX researcher, or software engineer. But first of all, if you are not familiar with the term persona or just heard about it in passing, I highly recommend you pause this video and check out our guide on what persona is and how to create it. You will find the link to the guide in the description of this video. And once one mastered the theory, we are ready to move on to practice. For our project, I'm going to create two personas, employee and HR. Our first persona is Ruth. Ruth is a 25 years old who previously worked in one company, and then she decided to try herself in a new company in a new domain. Her goal is to gain professional experience from her colleagues. It discourages Ruth when she has to figure out how things work by herself and when she lacks feedback. Quick tip, if you don't want to open a new tab to create a new persona, you can simply fill in a summary of your persona in the sidebar that appears right after you click on the persona's avatar. If you have more than one persona, simply add them to the map, like I'm doing right now with Terry. After describing personas, we need to specify the impact they produce. To learn how to do that, check out our next video.